On this Heroes Day, the struggle kids share stories of the hardships that they endured during the long and bitter struggle for independence. Although most of them were still young at the time, some believe that the conflict has had an impact on their lives, which is why they remain adamant about getting employment from government, despite the fact that they have to live in unfavourable circumstances.
The News on One spoke to several members from the struggle kids group that are camping at Brachwater. Most of them share the same background. Some say that they were taken from Namibia by SWAPO and taken to camps in Angola. They were told by the party that they were not safe in their own country, as SWATF was known for bombing schools. Ninambidi Shikongo is 37. He was born in Kwanza Sul in neighboring Angola, close to Kasinga. In 1988, their camp was attacked by UNITA forces and his mother was killed. He, on the other hand, was captured and forced to fight for UNITA for 10 years before he could escape back into Namibia. Rachel Penda is 41 years old and she still remembers how her parents contributed towards the liberation struggle. Although they are both still alive today, they do not get any assistance from government. Her mother had also lost her hearing during that time. Nation Jeremiah is 35. His father's job during the struggle was to drive a truck, delivering water to every camp. He believes that even if his father never wielded a gun in battle, the role that he played was significant to the cause. The struggle kids might be adults, but they always want to be referred to as the struggle kids because they were still young when their parents were fighting for the country's independence.
To be known as struggle kids also ensures that they are always remembered as those born to the heroes and heroines whose blood waters the country's freedom. Reporting for the News on One, I'm Joseph Sheefeni.